A heartily welcome at Van Drie Group. Van Drie Group is an integrated film production chain. We are going into the kitchen with Ragnar and Edgar, and we are going to prepare some byproducts. Some really nice products like the heart, the liver, the kidneys. And to be honest, the hanging tender is one of my favorites. I'm here with Ragnar Fredriksson and Edgar Beurs. Ragnar, you all know, he is one of the directors of the World Chefs. Edgar is one of our chefs. Edgar will join Ragnar in the kitchen preparing some veal dishes. My name is Patricia van Krieken. I'm the marketing manager of Van Drie Group. And I travel the world around with Edgar. Come and get inspired to cook with the byproducts of the veal. Welcome Ragnar in
thank
our
you.
Kitchen. Welcome Edgar.
Thank you.
Nice
good
to have
see you guys.
Here. It's
yeah,
an
thank
honor
you so much.
That you
good.
Join us.
Good to be here again.
Yes. I've got a surprise for you.
Oh yeah?
Yes.
What is that?
Look at this.
Oh, you're full of surprises,
yes,
Patricia.
I
wow.
love Always. Surprises.
Wow. Look that at looks
this.
Original.
Oh.
Wow. Look at this. Yeah.
This is exciting stuff.
Yes. Okay. Yeah, we got some different words for it. I don't know what the right word for it, so please help me. Do we call it offals or do we call it byproducts? Okay. Or what, how
a,
shall we
no,
call
it's,
it?
It's a good question because yes. offals, it means that it fell off. And really, this is like all these, what in Asia sometimes they call the spare parts for
yes.
joke.
Yeah, yeah. and, yeah, yeah
but
yeah.
we don't really have a good name that gives it a value. No. Because, I mean, these are, you know, all these byproducts, offal, spare parts. It's everything that is not the meat, you know, isn't it?
Yes.
And so it's
yes.
the heart, the liver, the trotters, the all these delicious things that have been cooked for centuries, you know, in any culture,
yes.
you know, because people didn't throw away.
No.
So,
no.
So yeah, so we need to maybe perhaps put the word out there and ask people to come up with better
yes.
ideas of what we call.
Yes. What yes. we call these
yes.
products.
The byproducts,
yes.
you know, the,
yes.
it's a real product, so.
Why not?
So, yeah.
It
yes.
is. Yeah.
So we've got here the scalded leg, the trotter,
yeah. the
also known as trotter, mm. isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We do have some different scalded products. I couldn't take everything because the counter is not big enough, so I made the choice.
Yeah.
We also scald the tripe, the trip.
Right.
Yeah.
As
yeah.
a product,
yeah.
And also the hat, for
yeah.
instance.
Also.
Yeah.
It was cooked a few years ago by a famous Dutch chef in a salt crust.
Yeah. In a salt
oh, yeah?
crust.
Yes.
Yeah.
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 Yes.
The whole head. Yeah. In a salt crust.
Yeah.
And then after that, they took off the crust and they take out the cheeks and the tongue and mm-hmm. everything mm-hmm. and the brain.
Wow.
You know.
Yes.
And everything was being served.
Yes.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yes.
So he
yes.
invented that thing. He it was his idea. Was it something traditional?
Yeah. No. It
it's
was his idea.
Yeah, yeah,
to do it like that.
Yeah. yeah.
We know it
like
from
that.
Fish. Don't we?
Yep. Yes.
Yeah.
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 Put fish
yeah.
in an,
that's correct.
In a salt crust.
And that's a good point. That's a good point.
Yes. He did it with a scalded head. So that was really. Spectacular
yeah,
to
very
see.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. So here we got the trotters. The
yes.
Yeah.
The trotters.
The trotters.
Yes.
Yeah.
And
there's a cheek.
And yes, cheek to cheek.
And sweetbreads.
Yes. And I did it in an other way. I brought the blanched heart sweetbread.
The heart sweetbread. Mm. Yeah. Yeah.
Actually, this one is famous all over the world. Mm. If you ask a chef, would you like to work with sweetbread? They say yes, please, the heart one. But we've got another one, and that's the throat
sweetbread.
That's
the one from the throat.
Right. Yeah.
So Edgar, if you please can explain us something about it.
I will move the tray over here, and then I can actually show you the sweetbreads from the throat.
That's also within the issue to value all the products.
Yes,
yep.
to value
yeah,
all the products.
Yeah.
Yes, because you know, these sweetbreads are actually much cheaper than the sweetbread from the heart, because this is has a bit more waste to it.
Yeah,
you
yeah.
see, and if we are going to cook this, then this bit here is of course you know the bit which is very easier to clean.
Yeah,
but once you get to here, you know it becomes more difficult. So what they would usually do is they would use the sweetbread from the throat. More for ragouts or salpicons or, you know, but We've also done tastings in France where I've actually prepared the sweetbreads from the throat and I've just fried it, you know. Mm-hmm. I've pan fried it as well.
Yeah.
And they and they still thought it was sweetbread from the heart.
Right, yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
So
it's got a bit more bite. There.
It has a bit more bite to it.
Yes.
It has a bit more bite to it. Yeah. It has a bit more.
But
a
also
bit more,
very pleasant,
yeah,
on the plate.
A bit more sinew to it. Yeah. Yeah.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
Well, that's the way to look at all kinds of products of food.
Yeah.
Nothing is less or more. They're
correct.
All equal, but they're different.
Yes,
and
precisely.
If you are able to see the difference between all the products, I think you're great to work with all kinds of products.
That's right. That's
absolutely.
Right.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Absolutely. Yeah, it's the work of the chef to make the product noble with the choices he does and all what you do, how you prepare and how you aromize it and
And the cheek, can we
prepare
it like
cheek,
this
or
the cheek?
Cheeky.
The cheek is of course this here, and here we have the two cheeks.
Yes, and they come by two.
They come by two. Yeah. What we always do, or what I always do, is I always take off this bit of fat. You could cook it like that, you know, straight away, but I always like to take this off, and then you can you could stew it, you know.
Yeah,
that's the best thing. That's the best thing.
Slow cooking, long time.
Yeah, stew cooking a long time.
Yeah, and you're seeing it more and more on menus these days. The
chicken, yes, you
it's
do.
Really nice.
You do. You do
see that. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's lovely.
Absolutely.
That reminds me. Let me get my mobile.
Yeah.
Hang on, guys. Look at this. What I've got here is...
Here's the cheek.
The cheek.
Okay.
This is the Veel Cuts app.
Yeah.
You can find it at veelcut.com or in your app store.
Yeah.
And look what we've done. We cut it in 3D. So if you are wondering what the cheek looks like, you can check out the Veel Cuts app and turn it around. And
you can see the whole cut of meat.
Yes.
Yeah, that's brilliant.
Yes.
Yeah.
And you can...
So you can...
You zoom in and
yes.
out.
Yes.
And you can...
So if you are wondering how the technical parts or these
And you have
parts.
That for all the different parts?
Yes.
The whole veal?
Yes. We've got 112 parts
that you
in
can,
this one.
So you can sort of have a better idea of what choices you have and how to prepare them. And
yes, and have
how
a look how
them
it's...
And,
So that's great. You can download it in your app store.
Brilliant, yeah.
Yes, for iOS or Android.
Yeah.
And for free, and it would be hopefully a help for chefs.
Yeah,
to
extremely useful.
Have a look.
Yes. Just to realize that there are more things out there than just the primary cuts. There are so many other, and you know, we talk offals, you know, but it's spare parts, offals. You know, we need to find a name
for it.
Byproducts. But they have beautiful names separately. You know, cheeks. It's such a cheek to cheek, and it's a fun and cute name. So I wouldn't see any problem selling it on a menu because it's you know, it has a swing to it.
Yes, it does.
You know,
absolutely.
The sweet bread, the cheek to cheek, and the trotters are coming your way.
Yes.
So it's all,
look
it's
at
all
this.
Very poetic.
Yes.
Look
it's
at this
beautiful
right
trotter, you know.
The trotter.
And that's such a...
I know that you are from Paris.
Yes.
Or actually, no, well, from Norway.
That's where
but
I live now.
You lived there for a long time.
Yeah, and we go to the pig trotters restaurant.
Yes.
Pierre Cochon.
Yeah.
But the veal trotter we see less. But I guess you make it the same way. It's the same preparation.
You can do it the same way. So you can cook it a long time, you know, and then you can actually take, you can open it up and open it up, and then you can stuff it, you know.
Exactly.
And with the other webcast, we've shown some cuts from the shortcut from the neck.
Yeah.
You could use that to make a beautiful filling.
Exactly. No, because that's a very special meat. It has a lot of gelatin, and it is very tasty and just delicious when it's done nicely. It's really
like
delicious
the
food.
Well.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yes, it is. Okay.
Yeah.
If you give me that plate, I'll come
more?
With another surprise.
Okay. More parts.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes. Look at this one.
Wow. This one has a
nice one.
This one has a big heart.
Yes. It's a heart. And we can smell it already.
Yes, special.
But please, can you explain what we can do with it?
Yes, the heart is a very is actually a very interesting piece of the offal of the byproducts.
Mm. Yeah.
It is for many European people not the one product that they would use very quickly. Because everybody thinks, oh, heart, that is a very, something, what are we going to do with that? There are beautiful things that you can do with a heart. I'm going to show you here, because this is actually the crown, which is still on it.
Yeah.
And what happens is that they actually, they always incision, they make an incision here to check. Patricia?
Yes, to check if the calf is healthy.
If the calf is healthy.
It's done in the slaughterhouse, if you get it, don't think it's wrong, but it's just safety to check it. Yeah. And they cut it also here, but in the end, it's not a big problem because you have to cut it anyway there to clean it.
That's right. Well, anyway, I'm going to show a bit of what we're going to do. First, for instance, we're going to take this off here.
That's a crown you take off.
That's a crown. Right. We're going to take this off.
That's for the broth?
That's for the broth.
Yeah, that's for the broth.
Right.
And then this one, we would take this off here as well. And what I'm going to show you inside, which is always very, very important, if you are going to prepare this, is that you have to take, you see here all these little membranes.
Yeah.
What we can do is we can actually use this, we can cook this as a steak.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And if you put on the frying pan, Patricia, then we can show people. But the other thing I've done is in the other pan over here, if you put that pan over here, Patricia, then we can show the people also. I've actually made a stuffed heart as well.
Okay.
So I made a filling. I made a and I put that in here and then closed it up and then sewed it together, and then you could serve that as well.
Right, so you slow cook that for a long time?
Yeah, you slow cook it for 4 hours.
Yeah.
But now I'm going to show you how to cut the steak from it.
Just a quick question. I'm not a chef. I'm more specialized in eating your dishes.
Yes.
Is 7 okay?
Seven is fine, actually. Yeah, yeah. So we're going to clean this here. Take these out. And this was really funny because not so long ago, Patricia and I, we did a workshop with some German bloggers, and we did the heart as well.
Yeah.
And they were absolutely surprised about the end result.
Yeah.
They were absolutely surprised about what you could do with the heart.
Exactly. And isn't that just to show that we need to keep these traditions alive?
Well, this is it, And like you said earlier to me, Ragnar, you said so many cultures they have got traditions and they take them with them. And they use all the products from the
from the calf. Everywhere you go, people never threw away. So you go back centuries, or even back to just my grandparents, they ate every part of the lamb in Iceland. It was lamb.
Yeah.
And we would eat every part of it. And the more I travel around, I see that it's delicious local dishes made with the kidneys. The heart, the brain, the liver, all these different parts. And that comes from long traditions.
It does.
And this is something that we are fighting a lot for, is the heritage cuisine in World Chefs.
Yes.
So we are soon going to launch a website where we're going to celebrate the heritage cuisine of all of our member countries, 110 member countries.
Wow.
And I think we're going to see a lot of recipes around the kidneys, the hearts, the livers, the offals, like we said, because this is really this is going back to the roots, and it's so amazing to see how you know, different in different cultures, they would use their own local spices. For instance, if you're in Asia, you have all those flavors. They loved cooking with the offals, using the soya sauce, yes, and the ginger, yes, and the garlic, yes, and the,
their
own spices. Whether you're in the Middle East or in Morocco, for instance, you know, using the cumin, lots of onions, and all these spices. So it always has a, you know, a different flavor. You can travel the world through these sort of recipes.
Absolutely.
Always the same ingredient,
yeah,
but really a distinct flavor from country to country.
Yes.
So.
Yeah. Nice.
Okay, we're going to put some butter in here. In actual fact, my father used to sell the heart.
Yeah.
In the he used to cut it like this in the butchery.
Yeah.
And he would sell it like student steak.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, because you know, as students, they don't have much money.
Exactly.
And of course, this is very, very, very cheap meat.
But there you go. So delicious but cheap. And isn't that typical? It's actually, as our society got richer, we sort of we started snobbing these idea of eating what we call offal, which is an awful name.
Yeah.
So we start snob those things and just like, I can buy myself a steak because that's expensive, so and I can afford it. So almost showing off your purchasing power. But you know, we're missing the beautiful traditions of cuisine.
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. I agree. Yeah. I agree.
Right. Mm. Wow. Is it also well known in France?
So the French, you know, they use a lot of the offals in all their cuisine, all their traditional cuisines.
Yeah, yeah. The kidneys, and, the brains, kidneys, brains.
But like I said, it sort of dropped off the menu in many places.
Mm-hmm.
It would be nice to see those traditional dishes come back on the menu. No, we mentioned a restaurant that's one of the old establishments, Pied Cochon. You go there and you have all the very sort of classic Escoffier dishes. And it's just a great sort of travel through time.
Yes, it
to
is.
To visit
it is.
Those. But definitely there is more innovation and more, like you said earlier, you know, use the whole head and innovate and recreate using those products, as you said. They are cheaper as it is.
Yeah.
They risk getting thrown away. We must not do that. We must not waste food in our world.
No.
And they are delicious. With great health qualities as well. And so we must use them.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I'm gonna take this over here.
Yeah, great. Mm. Okay. Mm, it smells lovely.
Yeah. Smells nice, eh?
Yeah.
So you just fry it like a steak, you know.
Mm.
And you keep it nice and saignant. You know, keep it nice and red.
Yeah,
we take it out.
Just like a minute steak.
Just like a minute steak.
A student steak.
A student steak.
Student steak.
A student steak,
Okay.
You see?
Great.
Okay.
And now that one.
Yeah.
So, do you... you just pointed out in Iceland you eat a lot of lamb.
Yes.
Do you also stuff the lamb's heart? Or?
Well, you know, I never seen it stuffed before, but definitely my grandparents, they would eat the heart and but they would in Iceland. We don't have a lot of culinary traditions going far back. It's such a rustic, robust country. We didn't have access to ingredients like fresh vegetables.
Or
we didn't get tomatoes, until like air travel was coming.
Yeah.
So it will be very basic flavors, nothing to compare to like when you travel southwards, when through the centuries you had the sun and access to fresh vegetables growing in your region and the spices and the herbs. So so it's a very basic, what salty water almost, carrot and potato if you can.
Wow.
So this is the... this is the stuffed heart, and this is a recipe from one of my from one of my hero chefs actually, and it's Mr. Witzigmann from Germany, Edgar Witzigmann. He had at the time a two Michelin star restaurant, the Tantris, in Munich, and he served this on his menu actually. Mm. Can I have the small tweezers, Patricia? Yeah, thank you. Wonderful. Mm.
Yeah, but that's really interesting, and that's very daring, you know, to keep on the menu these old traditional dishes.
Yeah,
I think you know, in today's society, we are going more and more back to that. We're starting to you know, think of environment, purchasing locally, so back to our own traditions. At the same time, traveling, of course, as you know, we're discovering other people's heritage cuisines, and there will be a more and more demand for that type of dishes and that type of products.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And so definitely we must be on our toes in World Chefs to teach our chefs about these parts and how to cook them, which is why we're here.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
This is why we are partnering.
Yeah.
So so it's a great eye-opener for us all, I think.
Yeah. We also presented in Bulgarian.
In Bulgaria we did, Patricia.
On the national TV with a cooking show. And we showed them how they can prepare a veal heart and stuff it like that.
Yeah.
And if you use everything, you've got the stuffing already.
Correct.
Yeah.
Wow, that's
Look
beautiful.
Look at that. That looks really amazing.
Look, beautiful.
It's great.
That is just so absolutely nice.
Yes.
And of course, you know, we have, you know, like Mr. Wietzigman, Chef Wietzigman, he would say, okay, you have to finish it off with a little bit of, you know, something which is always good, you know, some shallots and some carrots and you know.
Look at that.
Beautiful.
And then, it's a whole dish.
You know, and then what you are preparing here is a byproduct, and you make it into a Michelin star recipe. And that's the whole thing about that's the wonderful thing, I think, also about the World Chefs, is that you are facilitating programs to make people aware of all these important things that you need to know as a chef, you know.
Yeah, correct. And as I said, this is a part of our partnership and the Global Chef Challenge taking place soon, where we are also pushing our chefs and inciting them to revisit those parts that they are not using in the restaurants every day. So
that's right.
So here we have the steak. You know, the minute steak from the heart, and the stuffed heart, and that's all from the fresh product over
lovely.
There.
Lovely, look at the dish.
Yeah. Beautiful.
Yeah. Really nice. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
Shall we go to the next one, Patricia?
Next one.
Yes, yeah. Sure.
Okay.
Yes.
Come. Let's do it.
This is already
so
like
let's go on.
Let's hide behind and taste this one.
We have to wait till we finish.
We have more.
Right
we
now.
Have more. More to come. Yeah.
More to come. Yes. Can you pass on the tray with us?
Yes. Here we go.
And we swap it.
Yep, here
Thank
we go.
You.
Okay.
Here we are.
Here
we
yes.
Here we go.
Thank you.
More excitement.
Thank you.
No?
Yes.
It never ends. Just keep coming.
Yes. I choose the kidneys without fat and the kidneys with fat.
Okay.
Normally they come like that.
Yeah.
But what we do, we put them in a can. You can see it. Maybe Edgar can show it a bit. We put the fat in the can, and due to the weight of the kidneys, the fat will go around the kidneys.
Right, so
we cool it down, and then you've got the kidneys with fat.
Covered in fat.
Covered in fat.
So you can cook them like that.
Yes.
Yes, so you could actually cook them completely like this in the oven. You could put the oven on a high temperature.
I see.
And then you can put the kidney in, and it completely blows up and it becomes crackling.
Nice.
And
it keeps feeding with the moisture and the grease from the fat.
For that dish, actually, you often have to be in the restaurant so people can see what's happening.
It's really exciting
that it blows up, actually.
Very exciting.
Then the kidneys are cooking inside the fat.
Yeah,
nice,
yeah.
nice.
Yeah.
And the tongue.
And we have the tongue.
And the tongue,
We call it the Swiss coupe.
Yeah.
Because the bones are already taken off,
right.
So this is the clean tongue.
Yeah, yeah.
And
yeah.
we've got several ways to prepare.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes, we have several ways to prepare it. I'm first going to show you the kidney again.
Yeah.
Because the kidney, like I said, you could cook it in the oven.
Yeah. Just
straight
like that.
Away, like that.
Yeah.
Mm. Or what? The other thing you could do also, what we sometimes do when we do presentations, is we just slice it in steaks like this.
Ah.
And then you can just you can fry it like this, like a steak in your pan.
That
you know,
works,
and then
really
you don't need any fat.
Yeah,
you don't need any fat in your frying pan.
Yeah.
You just on either side, you know,
very
just
quickly,
very quickly, and then you have
to be red on the inside. And,
And
you don't pink have
on
to
the
clean
inside.
It. You just
You don't have to clean it. You just
amazing.
Do it like
slice
that.
Slice it.
Just do it like
funny,
that.
Funny, it has the same shape as an entrecote, so it's like a
yes.
It steals the shape and
yes.
it has a completely different.
So that's a nice way to serve it.
It is.
Gives
it
another
is.
Experience of.
It
looks
yeah.
visually beautiful. You know?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
And then, of course, you know, this one everybody knows, you know, or well, or most of the chefs know it, is that you have to, of course, take this out here. And then you can just cut off the knobs, you know. And then these little knobs, we would, you know, you could fry this.
Yeah.
Cut it in half, and then just fry it and sauté it
very quickly.
And
then again, you know, through the travels, you know, you see in Asia they love to play with these parts, the kidneys, and you know,
yes.
toss them in the soy sauce and with some spices, and every country has their own
have their own
recipes.
Yeah.
You know,
well, you know, funny you should say this about Asia, because Patricia and I, we were a few years ago, we were in Taipei,
yeah.
No, mm-hmm. yeah, and we had the tongue there, and that was very interesting, because we had the shabu shabu, didn't we, Patricia?
Yes.
Tell us more. Shabu shabu.
Well,
no,
shabu shabu. What they do, over there is actually. They what we would do here in Europe, we would cook this tongue. We would make a court bouillon, and we would put the vegetables in it, and we would put the tongue in it, and then we leave it to cook. And then we know when it is cooked, when you touch the tip of the tongue and it feels soft, then you know that the tongue has been cooked. And then you can take it out of the broth, or you can leave it to cool in the broth, and then afterwards you can take off the whole skin of the tongue.
Just we go back for a little because it went really quick.
Okay.
Why do we squeeze the tongue here?
Because this is
because
this is the most tough part of
the small end.
Because
it's
tougher.
It's more moving than
this has been moving, you know.
Yeah.
Okay.
For the whole
time.
Yeah.
For the whole lifetime.
Correct.
So this is very tough, and if this is if you can touch it with this with the skin on and it is soft, then the tongue is cooked.
Okay, thank you.
And then you peel it, and then you can slice it, and then you can serve it with whatever sauce. But we had this shabu shabu, and we were really surprised, because what they do is they completely strip the whole tongue. And then they freeze it, and then they slice it very thinly, very thinly, like a carpaccio, style. And then they just sizz it on either side of the grill, and then you eat it like that. And that's really that was an eye opener, a real eye opener, a very real eye opener.
Something happens with the taste and the structure of the tongue. It's a different taste.
It's a completely
sort of
different texture.
Charcoal grilling and
So
it's really nice, I guess, to make a threesome out of one tongue.
You can do it three ways.
A
and
bit
yes.
shabu shabu,
different
cooked
methods.
And one of my favorite ways to eat it is cooked, sliced, and then on the grill.
Right.
Because what happens then the sugars in the tongue from the feet will caramelize.
Yes.
And
that makes
a crunchy thing.
Yeah.
I really
exactly.
love that.
Yeah.
So
nice.
Oh yes, I do love it. Okay, then I've got one more piece. As I told you, we couldn't bring everything.
Right.
But look at this, guys.
Wow.
I brought a veal liver. Well, actually, a half.
Only a
half liver.
Yes,
but it's huge.
Otherwise, Edgar has too much.
Beautiful
work.
Piece.
Yeah, yeah.
And you've got a trick to clean it.
Yeah, yeah. That's right.
Can you show us?
It helps that the liver is already in half, Because what you need to do is you see here this skin. And this skin is completely running here over the whole liver. You always have to take that off. So you put your fingers underneath and then you can actually start peeling with your fingers, and you can open up and you can take off this skin, which is, if in some countries I have seen that they haven't taken off the skin, and right. then it's like as if you would have floss wire between right. your, you
exactly.
know, that doesn't, it doesn't, yeah. yeah.
And why do you not use your knife?
Well, because you can hardly do it with your knife, because you would take off so much liver already, you know.
Okay.
And it's much easier to do it with the back of your thumb or with your fingers. And then you can turn it over, and it has some of it on the other side as well.
Yes.
And we carry on with that as well. Yeah, that's always the tricky part, because you have to find it again, because there is a very small.
Yeah. But this is a great piece of meat, and
yes.
And. Even just from a health perspective, it's rich in iron.
Very rich in iron.
Really good in low in fat. And
Absolutely.
This is also a kind of piece what people eat in the autumn and winter.
Yeah.
Yes.
We think use it in the spring and the summer as well.
Yeah.
Yes.
And prepare it, for instance, on your grill.
On your grill,
outside. Exactly.
It's
really
lovely.
Yeah.
Leave it just pinkish
in
the inside.
Very high heat, and
that's really lovely. Yeah.
Season on the outside and leave it pink on the inside. It's beautiful. All you need is maybe just to spread some vinegar, balsamico vinegar, or reduce some butter and sherry vinegar, spread over.
Mm. Yes.
Yes, absolutely.
Look at that.
Mm. There you see, and we take this off here.
Yes. Because that's tough part, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, that's the tough part. I'm going to take this off as well. I'm just going to leave that here. And then I'm going to cut this out a bit. This is also, you know, very tough.
Yeah.
That needs to come out. Okay, and then, you know, once we have it like this, we can just slice it, and then we have
make some.
We have some beautiful
steaks.
Liver steaks.
That's it. Yeah. Beautiful.
Nice.
Yeah.
What can you?
But the other thing you can do, of course, you know, you can put this on the grill.
Yes.
You can fry it in a pan in some butter. Make whatever sauce with it. Make some sweet and sour combinations.
Correct,
it always works very well with liver. Onions, maybe some bacon even, you know, that would also work very, very well with liver. But you could also make this into a beautiful terrine, of course.
Yeah, sure.
Which I've done also, and which I want to show you also.
I thought I was from the surprises, but Edgar, how nice.
And there we go.
Shall I take it?
Yes, please.
Thank you.
So here's the the terrine.
Yeah,
the terrine.
Mm.
And I've actually cooked this. This is the the liver terrine. And what I did is I cut the liver into chunks about this big, and then I vacuum packed it. And I vacuum packed it with some red port, some red wine, some Madeira, a little bit of garlic, some rosemary, some thyme, some bay leaf. Left it overnight. And then the next day, I took out the marinade. And I put all the liver in the blender.
Yeah.
And I had 400 grams of liver. I put in 400 grams of beurre clarifique, so clarified butter.
Yeah.
3 eggs, and then through a sieve, and then you have a beautiful parfait of liver.
Wow, that looks beautiful.
Yes.
Now, if you would serve this,
look at that,
with a slice of brioche.
Yeah.
Then I would say that's it.
Exactly. You know. Et voila.
It's really
don't
nice.
Don't need anything else. You know? Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Amazing. Thank you.
So here we have, you know, lots of. It's. I find it always a pleasure to work with products like this, which are not very expensive in cost, but which are very great in taste.
Exactly.
Because, you know, liver is great in taste. You either love it or you hate it, you know?
Yeah, but it has a character.
It has a character. Yeah. I mean, a piece like heart, it has a character.
Yeah.
Kidneys, it has character. Yeah. And all these beautiful products, they are really worthwhile exploring and using and working with.
That's great. Yeah.
Agreed, chef. Yeah.
Oh, thank you so much. I think we are agreeing that not one part is less or more, but they're different.
Yes, yeah, absolutely.
Got all kinds of possibility for the chef in the kitchen.
Absolutely.
And thank you so much for showing us this and sharing it.
Yeah.
And we are going to keep up good work with all the veal.
Yeah, thank you so much. Yes,
yes.
Looking forward to it.
You.
Good.
Hey,
so glad.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You're welcome.